It is a common phenomenon to see fishermen and other travelers on water without wearing a life jacket. The few that take the initiative to wear them usually do not take note of other safety details associated with a life jacket. Ahmed Kawesi, the spokesperson of Swim Safe Uganda, takes us through the specifications one ought to consider before purchasing or wearing a life jacket.
Life jackets have a lifespan of keeping somebody above water. There are jackets which can let you float on water for 3 hours, 4 hours, 10 hours, 15 hours. But for the basics, the jacket that goes, that you need, that is a bit standard, is costs around $100. That is a lot of money. So most of the jackets, if you go downtown, are 70,000. So these are counterfeit jackets. They don't have whistles on them. They don't have the electric thing that you pull and it starts blinking. Because if, let's say, you fall in water at night, you need to pull something on the jacket so that it starts blinking. It's like a signal so that people from far can start seeing the signal and come and rescue you. And you need to have a whistle. So most of the jackets that we've seen don't have these tools on them. So it is really upset.
In the Saturday boat cruise tragedy, a number of people are reported to have died despite wearing life jackets. Kawesi explains that while this jacket can keep you afloat for some time, other factors are equally important in keeping you alive. Among them is one's body mass.
Before you purchase a jacket, jackets have weights they carry. So there's a jacket for 20 kilograms, 30, 40, 50, 60. So if you go for a jacket that is 40 and you're 45, you're going to drown. So you need to get a jacket that can easily keep you afloat. I mean, if you're 25, look for 30, because you don't know tomorrow you might get fat. So you always have a jacket that is that can carry weight more than what you have. You see, that's the problem.
We visited Gava Learning Site, where hundreds of water vessels set off and dock. Here, a life jacket costs between 20,000 shillings and 200,000 shillings, which most people cannot afford, while others deliberately shun them for various reasons.
Antero jikwata mungalo, manya antero yatori angeteriti senyonga sirisubira kola kabenji.
However, one can still use other options to stay safe in case of a water accident.
I always tell people, if you don't have a jerrycan, if you don't have a polythene bag, you need to stay relaxed, to stay afloat, which takes training. But we always say, if you're a fisherman, if you're somebody who is always on water, maybe carry yourself with a polythene bag all the time.
Tell me about the polythene
you
bag.
You blow air in the polythene bag, then you hold it tight. It's going to keep you afloat. Then if you have a jerrycan, hold the cover so that water doesn't go in and stay holding the jerrycan. Or if you find anything like a wooden, like wood floating, or anything that floats that's big enough for you to hold on, please don't let go.
Although world over, marine transport is considered one of the most comfortable means of transport, in Uganda it is very different, with discomfort and poor mechanical conditions of the vessels, which has contributed to accidents and losing of lives. It is estimated that every year at least 5,000 people die on Lake Victoria alone as a result of water accidents. The major laws governing water transport in Uganda also need serious scrutiny and revision to ensure safety of travelers. Among them is the Inland Water Transport Control Act, revised edition of 1964, and the Vessel Registration Act of 1904 and the Ferries Act. Rachel Nachuala, for Urban TV.